Good evening. At least $1,000 off your power bill. That's the promise from the Premier, who today brought forward a key budget measure to give families cost of living relief.
The rebates will cost the state $2.5 billion and will be available to Queenslanders in just a few months' time.
A Premier facing poll pressure and a public under financial pressure, all leading to a pre-budget cash splash.
This is the biggest contribution a state has ever made to support households with their energy bills.
Under the scheme, all households will receive a one-off $1,000 credit on their energy bills. Pensioners and concession card holders get more, $1,372. Although there's no increase for small businesses, whose rebate of $325 remains static. Cameron Dick is defending giving rebates to high-income earners.
How much about it is it buying an election as opposed to helping them out?
This is about helping Queenslanders in a time of need.
The opposition says they'll support the government's rebate legislation while blaming record wholesale energy prices and the Callide power station failure for having to.
Because under Labor, Queensland has the highest power costs in the nation.
This line of questioning is going to look pretty silly to Queenslanders when they start getting their electricity bills.
Last year's $550 energy rebate was included in the budget, but by bringing this one forward, it means Queenslanders will start receiving bill credits in July, just months before the election. The Premier says Queenslanders can't afford to wait, but after last week's YouGov poll showing just 19% of voters believe Labor's best place to handle cost of living, the government doesn't want to wait either.
How much did that poll have to do with today's decision?
As you all know, I've been talking about a measure like this for months now.
Live to State political editor Tim Avia. Tim, you've got some exclusive details on a major Queensland project.
That's right, Andrew. Tonight we can bring you information from confidential government documents on the Cross River Rail, a project which has already suffered lengthy delays and cost blowouts. Now, it's faced further troubles in recent days after industrial action by the CFMEU, with brawls breaking out between union and non-union members at work sites. Today, a federal judge ordered an injunction stopping the CFMEU from blocking or intimidating anyone entering the Cross River Rail site. But tonight, Night 9 News can also reveal these documents show a missed major milestone on the project. The documents say that trains were meant to be in the Cross River Rail tunnel and being tested in April this year. Now, that has not happened, and sources on the project say signalling and power works have not yet been completed. The government says the testing will now happen later in the year, but Andrew, Melissa, with industrial action ongoing, that will no doubt have an impact on that delay as well.
I'm sure it will, Tim. Thank you.